In this video, I shall talk about the journey of the C program from the time you type it into your editor like the CodeBlocks integrated development environment or in your notepad. Let us say I write a program which prints the message hello world and I give it the name hello.c. In your integrated development environment, when I press the shortcut key to compile or build, there is a series of steps or a series of transformations your code undergoes before it becomes ready for execution on your RAM or on your main memory. So let's say hello.c is ready for compilation. I press the build or the compile key. The file is first sent to the preprocessor. The preprocessor does things like include the header files, remove the comments, and do conditional substitution or macro substitution. So after the preprocessor processes the file, the output of the preprocessor happens to be a file by named hello.i. This indicates that the hello.c has been processed by the preprocessor. This hello.i is then next passed on to the compiler. The compiler takes hello.i and converts it into an file called as hello.s. Hello.s indicates that the compiler has taken your source program and converted it into a assembly language code. That's why you have the extension .s. Now this hello.s is taken by the assembler and converted into a object file or a machine code called as hello.o. But this file is still not ready for execution because in the hello.c, I had used a function called as printf. The code for printf was not written by me. All that I had done was in the standard input output.h, that is stdio.h, and indicated that I am using a printf function, and that code for that printf function is going to be provided or linked by the linker later on. So this hello.o goes to the linker. Then the linker takes your program or hello.o developed by you and the library code of printf and joins it along with your code, producing a file called hello.exe or a.out on Linux or Unix. Hello.exe is the name of the file produced on Windows. A.out is the name of the file produced on Linux or Unix. Now at this stage, your file from the secondary memory is ready to be loaded onto the main memory. This is where the loader comes into picture. The loader takes your hello.exe or a.out and pushes it onto main memory. From the main memory, the control is transferred over to the CPU for starting execution from the first instruction. So this gives you an idea of the journey of the C program from typing it into the notepad all the way onto execution. Now, in order to get a better understanding of this particular process, let us say I have a program like this. I will show you step by step what happens to this program when this program is only pre-processed, only compiled, only assembled, and the object code created. So what I am doing in the very first stage is I am taking this particular code and I am using a compiler called as GCC, which is available on Linux, Windows, and Unix. Using the GCC, when I compile this particular code with the E flag, it shall produce a file which has been pre-processed only. That means it has only been sent to the preprocessor. The output of the preprocessor happens to be a file called as print.i. Now, when this file is sent to the preprocessor, three things happen. The first thing is at this point, the contents of the header file stdio.h are copied. Then number two is this comment is removed because the job of the preprocessor is to remove comments. Number three, wherever this word string occurs, it is replaced with hello world. And the output, if you run this particular program on any of the machines, you're going to get this output hello world. So since I have pre-processed it only, this is how the output of the preprocessor is going to look. A lot of this is not going to make sense at now at this position because we're just beginning C. As you commence your journey, maybe over the next month or two, all of these points will be clear what all these things mean. So this is the output of the preprocessor. Now you can see here the output of the preprocessor is continuing. So this is all the output of the preprocessor. Here if you see, It indicates that it has included the header file stdio.h. Now, this is the name of the file we created, print.c. Now, if you notice here, the three things I mentioned happened. The include file has been included. Then the comment has been chopped out. This comment has disappeared here. And then this string has also disappeared. And this string has been replaced by hello world. So the preprocessor has done its job, what it is required to do. Now this print.i, when I then send it to the compiler will produce a file called as print.s. In print.s, what happens is the file print.i is converted into an assembly language code. So all of this code is basically the assembly language code which is created taking into consideration the hardware available on that particular machine or the that particular platform. So assuming this is an Intel machine, so this is a code representing or the code which is going to run on the Intel machine. So this is all example of your assembly language code. You can further look at it here. This is again the continuation of the assembly language code. Now this print.s, when it is passed on to the software called as an assembler, the assembler converts it from assembly language onto object code. So the name of the file now changes after processing by assembler is print.o. So this is what you see as the output of the assembler. So this is now object code or machine code. It's not making much sense to you because it is all assembly output, which is not assembler output, not going to make much sense. Through a small experiment, I am going to show you how the print.o is fused or joined with the printf library function from the library and how an executable is created. You need to understand when you create a file called as print.c, you have not written the code for printf. The code for printf exists in a library file with the file extensions ending as .lib or .a. So look for .a or .lib files in the directory where your compiler is installed. In some of those directories, you will find these library code. So what we are doing is, since we have produced a file called as print.o, we'll see how it is converted into a print.exe or a.out on Linux or Unix. So first what I am doing is on Linux, I am using the size print.o. If you see these numbers, this is showing you the size of print.o. It's a very small file because all that you have done is just the message hello world. So it's 97 is text, data is 0, BSS is 0, 97 in decimal and hexadecimal it is 61. Now when I pass it on to the linker, now you can see the size of print.exe has changed. Text is 1181, data is 520, BSS is 16, DEC is 1717, hex is 6b5 and file name is print. Don't worry what this text, data, BSS, deck and hex mean. We'll deal with that at the right time when we deal with functions and things like that. So here you have seen this was the output size when it was just compiled. Now you see when it was linked. So this should have given you a clear idea that the linker has done its job. Now through the size command, we get a rough idea about how the size of the output file increased from the object file to the executable file. Object file is the file ending with the extension .o. Executable is .exe on Windows and .out on Linux and Windows. This size increases because now the linker has taken the code of printf and joined it with your code. That is why the size has increased. Now if you are using the GCC compiler on Linux or Windows, you can use the different flags to produce the preprocessor output only, the output after compilation only, the output after assembly only. So what you can do is install the GCC compiler, just compile that program with hyphen e flag. You will get the output only after pre-processing. Hyphen C only after compiling. Hyphen S the object file. So this way you can understand the journey of your C program from the time you type it onto the process or onto the stage where it is ready for the loader to be loaded into memory. The .exe or the .out file is known as the executable image. That image is taken by the loader and put into the main memory and control handed over to the CPU for execution.